Hello, darling. Nice to see you. It's been a long time. You're just as lonely as you used to be. How's your new love? Are you happy? Hope you're doing fine. Just to know this means so much to me. You know, last year country music lost a legend, and the brotherhood of country music lost a big brother, Conway Twitty. In a career that spanned the decades, he took more than 50 songs to number one. On this night honoring songwriters, it's natural to remember Conway.
And now, one of the best friends that a song ever had. Please make welcome Conway Twitty!
Started with a song he wrote himself, and he would go on to write 17 of his own number one hits, love songs like this one.
I can almost hear the stillness as it yields to the sound of your heart beating. Bum, bum, bum. I can almost hear the echo of the thoughts that I know you must be thinking. Bum, bum, bum. And I can feel your body tremble as you wonder what this moment holds in store. Bum, bum, bum. As I put my arms around you, I can tell you've never been this far before.
When it came to finding a hit song, nobody did it better.
There's some great songwriters in this town. And when I get ready to record, I go through this town with a saying, you know. They all know that because we send letters to all of them, we call all of them, but they know that here's one artist that listens to everything they send.
Finding songs was his labor of love.
There's a lot of ways of saying what I want to say to you. There's songs and poems and promises and dreams that might come true.
One of the first times that I ever worked with Conway Twitty, as a matter of fact, in the 70s, I went to his office one day and Conway came up to me and he had a 45 record single on his finger and he was spinning it and he said, "You see this, Ron?" I said, "I sure do." And he said, "Well, you take this home and you listen to it." He said, "It's a smash, I'm telling you." Well, I took it home and I listened to it. I brought it back the next day and I told Conway that I didn't really like the song. Well, he said, "Okay." He said, "I'm going to record it." And he said, "Think it's going to be a big record for me." Well, he recorded it and it went to number one, and the song was "Happy Birthday, Darling." Of all the songs Conway Twitty gave me, which were many, and to this day I still don't understand why he gave me all those wonderful songs, and lo and behold, I turned them all down but one. But the one that I'd like to tell you about is a song called "I'd Love to Lay You Down." He called me in his office one day and he said, "Now, Ronnie," he said, "you've turned down all these number one records that I've given you." He said, "Don't turn this one down. It's a smash." And I said, "Well, what's it called?" And he played a little of it for me. And after he played, I guess he played about 3/4 of the way through. I said, "Now, Conway, that's too dirty. You won't ever get that on the radio." Well, that was "I'd Love to Lay You Down." And that was a big number one record for Conway Twitty.
Lay you down and softly whisper pretty love words in your ear. Lay you down and tell you all the things my woman loves to hear. I'll let you know how much it means just having you around. Oh, darling, how I love to lay you down.
songs, he made them hits, and he gave all the credit to the song and the songwriter.
No, Johnny, I included your song in an album that I recorded called Heart and Soul. And it's been said that Conway Twitty puts a lot of heart into a song. I've heard that.
That's true.
Along the road.
That's true.
Right?
Amen. Right.
But we all know that a heart's no good without soul. And in my opinion, the songwriter adds the soul. And I want to take this opportunity to thank you for giving me just a little bit more soul, Johnny.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's a lady that has meant so much to country music, songwriters, and especially Conway. Miss Loretta Lynn.
Thank you all. Thank you very much. I'd like to say that I told George just before the show started that I think that they give us the hard part to do. And all of you know that Conway Twitty and I were singing partners. And we had a special friendship that I think most singers don't have together. And I loved him with all my heart, and I know my husband did. And I'm going to try to do the first song he wrote and recorded. And went number one, pop, rock. It went every way. Now, it's low and it's too high, so here it goes. But Conway could sing it. People see us everywhere. They think that you don't care. But myself, I can't believe. I know it's only make believe. My one and only prayer is that someday you'll care. My hopes and dreams come true. My one and only you. No one will ever know how much I love you so. My only prayer will be someday.
Goodbye, darling. Gotta go now.
Gotta go now. To find a way to lose these memories of the long and lonely truth.
to forgive me. Come back, darling, I'll be waiting for you.